Welcome to Beer and Irons Heating a Camp Cast Iron Dutch Oven. We're going to learn how to heat our cast iron camp Dutch ovens for baking, frying, and roasting. In preparation for more outdoor cooking this summer, we're going to start off our cast iron camp Dutch oven article series with a how-to in heating the cast iron Dutch oven. First and foremost, and pretty please with sugar on top, don't overthink this. You'll never, ever, ever get a perfect spot-on temperature in your cast iron Dutch oven. If you can remember the basic gist in this video, you'll feel free as a bird and appear to be as smart as any great outdoor chef. This is a 12-inch deep cast iron Dutch oven. 12-inch seems to be the most popular size, and I'm going to show you how to heat a 12-inch cast iron Dutch oven. But if you can get this down, you can heat any size Dutch oven. This is a 10-inch regular cast iron Dutch oven. And this is a 12-inch cast iron Dutch oven, but with a bit different lid shape. This Cabela's cast iron Dutch oven has a thermometer notch. Some call it a steam vent, and I guess that'll work too. Camp Chef makes a cast iron Dutch oven similar to this Cabela's model. Though my personal preference is Lodge, Camp Chef comes in a close second because of that thermometer notch. If I'm cooking a meal such as a prime rib or even a whole chicken, having that thermometer notch sure comes in handy. For this video, we're going to use the Lodge cast iron Dutch oven for demonstration purposes. Later, I'm going to cook using the two Dutch ovens, the Lodge and the Cabela's. Keep in mind that the manufacturer makes no difference in how you heat your cast iron camp Dutch oven. Do you see that number 12? That's the diameter of the Dutch oven. If you've never seen a camp cast iron Dutch oven, the bottom is not flat. There are usually three little short legs that allow for the heat source to be placed under the cast iron camp Dutch oven. Do you remember that number 12 on the lid? We're going to use that number and do some basic math in order to properly heat the Dutch oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 177 degrees Celsius. Here's the basic times two rule, or rather guideline. I don't like rules. Multiply the diameter of your Dutch oven, whatever size you have, by the number 2. That's how many charcoal briquettes you're going to need. In this case, we're using a 12-inch Dutch oven. 12 times 2 is 24, and we're going to need 24 briquettes. To start learning how to heat the cast iron Dutch oven, use briquettes and experiment with other heat sources later. We're going to discuss the three cooking methods and the way to heat the Dutch oven for each method. We're going to talk about baking, which I consider the most common, frying and searing, and also roasting. I use a charcoal chimney to get my briquettes ready. Tongs are very helpful in counting and manipulating all those little hot briquettes. For a 12-inch cast iron Dutch oven, we take the number 12 and multiply it times 2. That gives us 24. I always start off with a bit more briquettes than that suggested number. This lets me have options later. We're not going to light these briquettes yet. I'll show you some real cooking later. Right now, we're just going to get the basics of the heating process. We're going to start with baking. This is how I cook most of my meals. Use the times 2 rule, or guideline. We have a 12-inch Dutch oven. 12 times 2 is 24. And like a birthday whoopin', add one or more to grow on. Do you see that number 25 and 26? Those will be left in the charcoal chimney to help light up the next batch of charcoal briquettes later if we need to, or if we need them for whatever reason. It's amazing how you'll end up with a charcoal chimney that you think has 24, but really only has 22. That's the benefit of two or more to grow on. Heat distribution is different depending on if you're baking, frying, or roasting. We're going to bake and we need to know where to place our charcoal briquettes. Here's a tip. Use a metal garbage can lid with the handle ripped off. It makes perfect cooking platforms and will fit the windshield I make perfectly. I'll show you that in a bit. Do you see here at the bottom of the oven? See the diameter of the bottom? We want to add our coals and spread them out in a circle just a little bit bigger than the diameter of the bottom of the Dutch oven. We have 24 briquettes to use. Now, where do we place them? For baking, we take that number 24 and we divide it by 3. 24 divided by 3 is 8. We get that number 8. Take 8 briquettes and place them in a little circle that's just a little bit wider than the diameter of the bottom of that cast iron Dutch oven, and space them out somewhat evenly. Set that Dutch oven over that ring of coals. Make sure the legs are sitting flat on the surface and not cattywampus on one of them briquettes. We've taken a third of those briquettes and put them on the bottom. 8 is a third of 24. 1/3 of 24 is 8. 2/3 of 24 is 16. If 8 are on the bottom, we double that for a total of 16 briquettes for the top. 8 on the bottom and 16 on the top is a total of 24 briquettes. Now to review for our coal count, you'll take the diameter of the cast iron Dutch oven and multiply that number times 2. That's how many briquettes you're going to need total. And that number's constant for either baking, frying, or roasting. Specifically to baking, to bake, we're going to divide that total number by 3. Take 1/3 of the briquettes and place them under the oven, and take the other 2/3 of the briquettes and place them on top of the Dutch oven. If you get this baking ratio down, you'll have most of what you need to cook in a cast iron Dutch oven. Now remember, these numbers are based on a 12-inch cast iron Dutch oven. Follow this formula based upon the Dutch oven size. A 14-inch will need 28. 12 inches, of course, needs 24. A 10-inch will need 20. And if you have an 8-inch Dutch oven, it'll need 16. Do you get it? Now let's talk about frying or heating the Dutch oven for sauteing, searing, and browning. Like on a stovetop, all of that heat needs to be directed to the bottom of that cast iron Dutch oven. Using the same times 2 rule, and based on your Dutch oven diameter or Dutch oven size, calculate how many total briquettes you're going to need. A 12-inch Dutch oven needs 24 briquettes. Just place every single one of those briquettes under the Dutch oven. We want all of the heat directed toward the bottom to fry, saute, brown, sear, or even boil. You'll find most of the recipes will start with frying, sauteing, or searing, and then we'll move into baking. And I'll show you a real cooking example later in the video. Roasting in a Dutch oven is something I do on an occasion. If I'm roasting something for more than an hour, I'll usually do my baking method. Using this roasting method is much less frequent in my camp cooking. The formula is almost as easy as frying. Once you get the total briquette count, put half on the bottom and half on the top. My 12-inch Dutch oven needs a total of 24 briquettes. Put 12 on the bottom and then put 12 on the top. There's a couple of different briquette patterns for roasting. Either one of these patterns will work just fine. Once you have the bottom briquettes settled, place the Dutch oven over the briquettes and add the other half of the briquettes on the top. Here's a quick summary before we move into a few specifics and get into a real cooking example. To get the correct briquette count, you'll need to consider the diameter of the cast iron Dutch oven that you're using. Take the diameter number and multiply that by 2. This gives you the total briquette count that you're going to need for that Dutch oven. To bake, place 1/3 of those briquettes on the bottom and 2/3 of those briquettes on the top. If you're frying, sauteing, or searing, just place all the briquettes at the bottom of the Dutch oven. If you're roasting, take half of those briquettes and place them under the Dutch oven, and the other half put them on top. Before we move on, let's learn how to increase or decrease the Dutch oven temperature. Now we know how to get our ovens up to around 350 to 374 degrees Fahrenheit. That's about 177 to 190 degrees Celsius. But what if we want to turn the temperature down or turn the temperature up? This method will allow you to calculate and better turn down or turn up the temperature by about 25 degrees Fahrenheit or 14 degrees Celsius. Now, we're not talking about turning down to these temperatures, but adjusting the temperatures by 25 degrees Fahrenheit or 14 degrees Celsius intervals. All you need to know to turn the heat up by 25 degrees Fahrenheit or 14 degrees Celsius is to add 2 briquettes. To turn down the heat by 25 degrees Fahrenheit or 14 degrees Celsius, all you need to do is take 2 briquettes away. Now, what about wind and weather? I've cooked in wind and rain, but only if it's a drizzle. Unfortunately, charcoal briquettes will not stay lit when they're pummeled with rain. Wind is something we can control somewhat. Even when it's blowing the squirrels out of the trees, or when we're 3 sheets to the wind, we can ease the wind on our Dutch ovens by using a windshield. I love to use a windshield, and use one just about every time. I make these out of old license plates and key rings. I'll show you how I make these on a future video. Speaking of future videos, if you like this one and want to follow us here on beerandiron.com, consider giving us a little thumbs up, clicking that subscribe button, and giving us a little ding on that dinner bell. Now for some real cooking, and put a couple of these heating methods to work with some real fire. Get everything organized. I do this before I light my fire. Now I got that song stuck in my head. In a charcoal chimney, it does not take long to get these coals burning hot. We're prepping enough briquettes for two 12-inch Dutch ovens. Often, you're going to need to combine two different heating methods, and I'm going to show you this while I prepare this chicken and rice recipe. We need to shallow fry or pan fry the chicken first and then saute the onions and garlic before we add our rice, liquids, beer, and then top it with the seared chicken. And then we'll bake it a bit until the chicken comes to temperature and the rice is thoroughly cooked. We're going to need to first fry and then saute, and then after all that, we're going to need to bake our dish. We're going to be cooking this in a 12-inch cast iron Dutch oven, and we're going to need 24 briquettes under each. Notice in my charcoal chimney, I have a few extras. Those are my one to grow on briquettes, and I will start my next batch with those. I have most all of my ingredients already prepared, but there's always those fireside preps you need to make. Let your Dutch oven heat up while you get these short tasks done. Once your Dutch ovens are ready for cooking, just treat it like a skillet on the stovetop. For frying, sauteing, and searing, don't put the lid on the Dutch oven. Moisture will build up and things won't work very well at all. Open air always when frying, searing, or sauteing. Do you see that wind hitting our windshield? That'd be blowing our heat away. I have some chicken breast meat I'm going to prep as well. Another must-do when cooking is to rotate the oven as you cook, about every 10 minutes. When I'm frying, I rotate the food and not the Dutch oven. I'll show you the rotation technique in a bit as we bake this dish. Just give things a check now and then to see the progress. Nope, not there yet. We're looking for golden brown. Here's a tip for you. If you know you're going to need more briquettes to do more sauteing and baking, and we will, go ahead and start a new batch of briquettes on the ones we left in that charcoal chimney. Remember the one to grow on? Let's check again. Oh yes, that's perfect. For multiple step recipes like this one, keep a spare Dutch oven nearby the fire to keep it warm. This is where we're going to hold our chicken as we prepare the rest of our ingredients. Plus, there's going to be a bit of broth that will form in that warming pot, and we'll add that to our recipe later too. You may need to periodically change out your spent charcoal briquettes as you cook. If you find your second batch is not frying with as much zeal, change the briquettes out with new ones that you've already started. Do you see those spent briquettes and those new briquettes? There's the new ones, and there's the spent ones. Often, I'll just leave the ones that are almost spent and just add fresh briquettes right in there with them. Remember to keep things rotated. So far, we've added some new briquettes to keep the sauteing and searing going. Today is a bit windy, and we're both pan frying the chicken and sauteing the vegetables. There are times when you'll have to add briquettes mid-cook. Also, keep in mind that we're combining cooking methods here. We are first pan frying and then sauteing. Next, we're going to bake. Most of the time, you should start with a set of fresh briquettes whenever you're changing cooking types like we are from frying, where all the heat is at the bottom, to baking, where two-thirds of the heat is on top and the other third is at the bottom. Between those moments when you're stirring, be sure to fire up a new set of briquettes. That way, we can start the bake with a fresh set of hot briquettes. We're creating two meals here, chicken and rice with chicken breast, like we're setting up here, and later I'll set up one with chicken thighs. There's that broth from the warming pot. Remember, the warming pot was just another smaller Dutch oven to hold the chicken near the heat while I prepared the rest of the ingredients. Now we're adding the pan-fried chicken thighs to the other pot. I think the chicken thigh version looks and tastes better, but my family favors the chicken breast version more. Look there, more broth from that warming pot. That broth is created when the chicken rests while we sauteed the vegetables. I ain't about to miss out on that flavor infusion. Place the lid on your pot and set the pot to bake. I pull the pot of chicken and rice away from the fire and set it aside. Those charcoal briquettes are somewhat spent, but not to be wasted. The campfire will definitely appreciate them. Just dump them out and start with fresh briquettes. Now we're going to a different cooking method, baking. We are baking now with a 12-inch cast iron Dutch oven. We need to do our math. 12 times 2 is 24. 24 divided by 3 is 8. We need to put 8 under that Dutch oven. That makes sense, right? Too much heat under that oven will cause that rice and those thick soups to burn. Just place the coals as evenly as you want. But don't worry if they're not perfect. No worries. Place the Dutch oven over those coals, and we need to put the remaining briquettes on the top. We had 24 initially and used 8 already underneath it. Put the other 16 on the top of the Dutch oven. The briquettes look a bit jumbled, but they're really organized. Let's look at it a bit closer as we put on the windshield. There's 8 briquettes on the right side of the handle, and there's 8 briquettes on the left side of the handle. Don't overthink this too much. Perfect circles are not necessary. And remember, we're going to be rotating our heat about every 10 minutes. And with that, let's talk about rotating the heat as we load up the Lodge cast iron Dutch oven with its collection of hot briquettes. There are many factors that can cause hot spots and cold spots as we cook. Sometimes briquettes will just fizzle out and forget to show up for work. Wind on one side of the oven can cool it down. And how close is one oven from the other hot oven? Using your lid lifter handle, grab the Dutch oven handle and lift it just a bit. Give it a 1/3 of the way turn to the left or the right. Now, take the lid lifter and grab the Dutch oven's lid handle and turn it 1/3 of the way in the opposite direction that you turn the oven. Watch again and keep an eye on that 12 on the lid. Turn the whole Dutch oven about 1/3 of the way in one direction. And then turn the lid without lifting the lid in the other direction. The 12, or whatever landmark you're watching on the Dutch oven, should be about back in the same spot that you started from when you're done turning the oven and the lid. Now, I don't know about y'all, but I'm hungry. I could eat the north end of a southbound polecat. Let's take a peek and see how our meal turned out. Just to make sure we heated up things right. Oh my gracious. I tell you what, you put that there on your head and your tongue's liable to beat your brains out trying to get to it. That's gonna be yum yum. The main thing is the chicken. Make sure it's up to temperature. Checking with a thermometer is okay, but if you cook enough, you'll get to know done, and done's gonna be a good friend. Underdone chicken is one thing, but underdone rice? Nuh-uh. Gotta check that for sure. We've talked about heating up the cast iron Dutch oven. Now we need to take it off the heat and prepare it for meal serving. Put the lid back on the pot. Then remove the spent briquettes one by one with the tongs. If I'm in an area where leaving these burning may cause a problem, I keep a metal dog water bowl nearby full of water, and I drown each one of these spent briquettes as I remove them. Now how does that chicken breast meal look? Look at that. One of them dudes is done sunk. I'm going for it first. Perfect, and no stickage or burnt stuff either. Success. Now how do we rid our Dutches from their ashened embrace? Make sure all the briquettes are removed. Even a tiny briquette can cause a problem. Use a hand brush like this one made of straw. Avoid those plastic ones. If they melt on the metal, it's going to cause a mess. I brush them off for the trip home and then give them a final cleaning there. Or I clean them for the next camp meal if we're staying longer. And we're going to be creating breakfast in these in the morning. And once again, we've come to the end of our time together. I appreciate each and every one of y'all for watching. I sure do hope you've learned something today about how to heat the camp cast iron Dutch oven for baking, frying, or roasting. My name is Sule, and I love to share the magic that comes out of my black pots and pans. I want to know what you got planned for this summer, camp, Dutch oven, cooking, and all. Tell me what you got in that fire. And that's about it, y'all. Y'all take care and keep on cooking in those cast iron beauties and enjoying those frosted glasses full of that fermented barley pop. And we're going to see you next time on beerandiron.com.